We got to put a brand new track on it, because that one is torn in several places and missing the studs. I've watched several YouTube videos and read many of a snowmobile forum, and I have to remove or loosen them bogey wheels and those adjusters, and then I got to take out these four carriage bolts, remove the undercarriage. Before I did that, obviously, I put it up on these lobster crates, and I'm going to heist the back end of the snowmobile up using that winch right there to get it up off the ground, because I'm old. And then I'm going to drain this crankcase right here of the gear oil. And the stickler is on this particular snowmobile, it's an older one, the fact that it has a manual reverse, and that case right there will not come out by that plastic pan. That's been the stickler according to the forums of getting this apart. So I, by researching and talking to these guys on these forums, I was already to just sell the snowmobile and buy another one, because it sounded like a disaster trying to fix this. But I talked to that guy, and he said to heat that pan up right there with a heat gun and pound a block of wood in between that and that crankcase, and that would allow you enough space to get that cover off. And he said most people frig up by messing with this linkage here. So he said take it off in as few pieces as possible. Unbolt it here, here, and here. And just slide it back. Leave it alone. Don't mess with it. If you don't adjust it, shouldn't, when you put everything back, it shouldn't need any adjustment. As most people screw the reverse up for that fact right there. But then we have to take this crankcase off. I got a new seal ordered, and the gears and the springs and stuff in there, I'm going to try to be meticulous about taking that off and laying it out on a paper so it goes back in that same order. Then it comes down to taking out the carriage after those four bolts, and you probably can't see that, but there's a drive gear underneath there, and I have to take that out. And once the new track comes tomorrow, I just have to put that in and redo the steps. Hopefully. Sounds good, right? We'll see how it goes. First of all, I'm going to attempt this area, because this is supposed to be the hardest before I unbolt anything. By the way, I did take the springs off and take the exhaust pipe off so I could actually see what was going on in there. The exhaust goes right there. It's attached by springs. And it's sitting right there. Finish this beer and I'll get started. I don't have to work on that one yet. Well, I cut this block and I'm trying to wedge it down into there, and nothing seems to be going as planned. I'm trying not to lose my cool and walk right around this son of a bitch about six times with that friggin' split mall right there, and drag it out the driveway to the junkyard. Sit down, have another beer, try to think it out. If I don't work on shit, it's cheaper to just have somebody else do it. I don't get no patience for this shit. Well, I heated that pan up, and if you can see that or not, but heated up with a heat gun and pounded a block of wood in there, and I got a lot more clearance than I had before. So we're gonna try that and see if that's enough. If it's not, I think I'm just gonna cut that piece out, and I don't see why I just can't patch it with a piece of plastic or something and put some 5200 marine sealant over it, and I can't see why it wouldn't be all right. I mean, it ain't like it's a brand new sled or anything. It's a 2000. I think it's 17 years old. If I get another couple seasons out of it, I'd be tickled. So we'll try that. I guess next is the drain plug. Well, the guy in the forum said, good luck getting that drain plug out of there. Man, he wasn't just kidding. Geez, that was in there some tight. Thought I was going to twist that wrench off, but she snapped free. So, on to the next part. We're going to take these four bolts off this case, if I can get to them. Those 7 o'clock one is a, looks like it's going to be a bitch. But, we'll see what we can't get. Well, I've got all the chain case bolts out, except for one bottom one. It's all loose. I finagled a swivel-ended wrench, ratchet wrench in there, and I can't get it out all the way. I can wait till my kid gets home. He's got small hands. He'd reach right down in there and get it. So, the next thing was take this linkage off. The guy said to take it off in as few pieces as possible and don't mess with the adjustments. You can just lay it back and put it right back on the same way. So that's what I'm on now. Just taking these. I just took those two bolts there. I got to pop that one right there out and take that bottom arm off right there. And I'm just going to lay this whole works backwards. Well, the linkage came off relatively easy, and I just took it off in 3 bolts and just pulled the cotter pin and pulled the whole works. I didn't adjust any levers or anything, just pulled it right out and left it in one piece. So that opened me up quite a bit. I left this bolt in here that the linkage went on. No sense to take it out if I don't have to. But I'm keeping everything in that bucket. It goes off this snowmobile, and all the wrenches that I use in this operation I'm going to lay here, so I'll have the tools to reassemble raised in my hands. Now one more bolt here and we'll see if we can't get this off. And I also got to take this bolt here off, and this one last crankcase bolt here. I don't know if you can see this or not. Lighting sucks in here. Well, I can see by the looks of this that somebody's been in here before. For one thing, there's no cotter pin in that nut right there, which is supposed to be. And when I took this cover off, the cover sprung right to one side, means that bolt that holds that whole works down in there has come loose, and I'm surprised that it didn't bother while he was riding it. Whoever's been in there before, I bet, did not put any Loctite on it and it came loose. So this is posing a slight problem on getting this case off now, and I'm not sure what to do. Figure it out, I guess. Okay, I had plenty of room to get it off. I just had to depress that spring. And whoever was in here before didn't tighten that up. And that bolt came loose. Didn't damage anything. But do not lose this washer right here. This washer goes right on the end of this shaft. And if you don't put that back on, that will not shift right and mesh in correctly. So be careful. Make sure that washer goes back on before you put it back together. So far, so good. I'll pop this case out of here and slide those gears off in the proper order. And then I'm going to lay them right out on paper so I know what goes back in what order. No guessing. It looks to me like this chain has got a fair amount of slack in it, and I could have used an adjustment, I'd say, for a while. But the gears look good. And on we go. Yeah, there's no doubt in my mind that somebody has been in here before, because there's Permatex gasket sealer all over underneath that gasket. Look how loose this chain is. This should be like this. This should be nice and tight. And there's no cotter pin here. I'll have to make sure to replace that. And I gotta slide these gears off in the exact way, because this gear is slightly different than that one, and they have to go back in that exact order. So I'll be taking them out. But I'm feeling a little more confident. I'm going to back this adjuster off here slightly and remove the chain. And this is the only part I was really worried about. Other than that, I'm feeling more confident all the time with this job. But yeah, I'm glad I ordered a new gasket. I won't be here for a few more days, because I didn't order it till a few days after the other parts, but I can have it all back together except for that cover. So that's where we are. Onward we go. Let's have a friggin' beer. Alright, I took the gears all out and I laid everything out so I know exactly how it goes in. I didn't mess with things as little as possible, because I know nothing about this stuff. So I can put it back in exactly the way it came out, hopefully. So I'll instruct my kids to not mess around right here till I get this back together. And this over here, it actually looks pretty clean in there. I don't see that I've disturbed anything. I do see a snap ring down there. I'm not sure if I need to remove that or not. But we'll see. But I will need to, that's the whole part, is to get that shaft. I got to take the secondary drive off and pop that. Yeah, we'll get to that. But we're pretty deep right now. So the next part, now that I've got all this off, is to jump onto the other side and see if we can't free some stuff up over there and see how much further I gotta go here. I may have to take this snap ring off right here. Let's not rush stuff. Now we're into the other side of the machine. Pull this light off here. Pulled that pin out right there. There's a pin that goes right through there. I already pulled it. And we'll just pick this right up out of here. This gives us a view of our belt. Our primary drive clutch and a secondary driven clutch. I only know all these names because I've watched the YouTube videos. Trust me, I've never been into one. Ever. I don't know a thing about it. It's all brand new to me. If I look like an idiot doing this, you're probably right. So, somebody said I didn't have to remove this secondary, all they've got to do is get to that speedo cable right there and those three bolts, but they don't look too easy to get at without removing this secondary clutch. Actually, the speedometer cable didn't even look like it's attached down there. I think somebody's been into this baby before. Well, the next shot, I believe I could actually, if my arms and hands weren't big, and I could get underneath there and get that bolt out of there, but I don't think it's that big a deal to take this driven clutch off here. I'm just going to pop one of these 3/8 bolts off and put a longer screw in, which will spread those sheaths. I'll remove the belt, and then I can take a 1/2-inch wrench, remove this, and just pull this secondary right off. I believe there's a keyway in behind it. I'll be careful to make sure that doesn't get knocked out or lost, but that's the next step. I'm not going to try to do this stuff on camera, because how are you going to do it one-handed? I'm the only one here. The way to spread these sheaths is you take one of those bolts out, and then you get the sheath separation tool, and that'll thread right in that bolt hole just like this. Start to film at the same time, but to watch that'll spread those sheaths apart. You can take the belt off. Like that. Okay, then you take your belt off, take your tool back out, put it back in your toolkit, and
that's where the toolkit is.
Right. Screw the screw back in. Just partially. Because we're not going to. And then we have to get a 1/2-inch wrench. Pause it. You take a 1/2-inch socket. Hold on to your. Right up. This is obviously moving that shaft on the other side, so on reassembly, I'm sure I'm going to have to take and wiggle this back and forth to align those gears enough to put down. Be very careful. See the amount of washers on here? It's not on there for no reason. Just to align that clutch and the amount of spacers to for the deflection on your secondary. Now this secondary should slide right off in here. Nice and easy. So, be sure to not lose anything, any shims or anything. Leave everything together is a keyway. The deck guard right there. It seems in there pretty solid. We'll leave it. Be careful. I'm going to put this right back in there. Lug it over to the bench. And just set it down. The shim's here. This is all to do with the adjustment of your secondary, how it lines up with your primary. So we gotta be careful not to mess with any of that. But this is nothing to do. This just operates that whole shaft. The bearing feels good. So we won't even mess with that. Now, the speedometer cable was just sitting in here. Like this. This piece was way back in here. And it was just sitting like this. So I don't know how that was even functioning, because this wasn't even screwed. That tells me that somebody's been into this before. So, but we'll fix that. So I've taken that off. They're going to take these three bolts here. They look to be half inch. And we'll remove those and pull that cap off. Take these three bolts off. Pop this cap off. Alright, we'll pop this cap off. I get the nuts all off. Make sure there ain't nothing gonna fall here. There's the end of the speedometer rigging. We're gonna set this on the bench, all intact. So we gotta take this whole undercarriage out with these four bolts right there, and one, two on the other side. Okay. After looking it over closely, I don't think I have to take that snap ring off. All we have to do right now is unbolt the carriage and slack off that nut right there on that bogey wheel and reduce the tension on the track. And we can take this undercarriage right out. There we go. I just didn't have the things backed up. Yeah. Yeah, you gotta slack those adjusters right off. There we go. There. Man, now the track's all loose. Now all we gotta do is unbolt the four carriage bolts and we'll have it off here. I couldn't find anything to support underneath the carriage, so I just tied it with a rope through the track right there. The other side of the snowmobile, and that should hold it fine. Hopefully. When we took it trying to get the carriage bolts out, the third and the fourth one, you can get one out which can't get the other because it spins in here and there's not enough room to get a Stilson wrench or anything. So I would say if you don't have a decent amount of tools or a chain wrench or something, you're going to be pretty much screwed doing this job. There. Now, I'm gonna hold this where my son is, and he's gonna take the other bolt out because it spins on this shaft here. So we'll take it out now. But I'd say if you're gonna do this job, you better have a chain wrench. Okay, so we dropped the carriage and wiggled it out. It's not an easy task. So now that leaves us with the track, and I just gotta pull that shaft off to the side and I can drop that whole works right out of there. Okay, so here we are so far. We had to take the nuts that you see me screw on earlier, we had to actually take them back off because this gap was on the back side and it didn't allow the shaft to be, you had to pull it this way and drop it down and then pull it out of the machine. So now we have put the light up and you see we cleaned it all out. And I guess we're golden. She's all out. The old track is on the floor, waiting for the new track tomorrow. Man, I've never been so deep into anything in my life. Not really all that mechanically inclined. I got plenty of tools, but I don't know. See you tomorrow. I'll tell you right now, if I had to do this job again, knowing what I know now, after my first time doing it, when I get through it, I would take and do this job on its side. I would keep rolling this. If I had to get to this side of the machine here, I would roll it over so I can get to it. If I had to get to that side over there, I would roll it over to get to that side. I think gravity is your enemy in this position. But if you rolled it on its side, I think gravity would be your friend first, getting carriages back together and shafts in there. It's my first time doing it, but I think if I had to do it again, I'd do it on its side, back and forth.
Bob! What are we doing?
We're gonna fix her.
We're gonna fix her. I'm drunk and I got a fucking gun. Ha! Oh man, we've been drinking all day. No, not him, me. He finally got out of work and he's gonna help me put this up in there. It's a two-man job getting this friggin' track back up in here. Trying to not launch the F-bombs. But I'm a drunken pirate and sailor. And that's what we do. So if I launch one, fuck it.
Yeah.
All right. The objective is we're going to put this track up in that tunnel. Put that drive shaft in. I already got the strap and a rope here to kind of take a little weight off the track so we don't have to mess around too much. But I'm gonna try to crowd that track up in that tunnel so he can get that up in there, and that's the story, and we're sticking to it. Are we ready?
I am.
Ready? Let me just do it while they're watching. All right. Let me just hold this right up in there. Can I crowd that? That ain't working, is it?
I think.
Can I just crowd that right there? just set that down for a second. That camera ain't working. Okay.
All right. Between me and my stern man, Bob J, bring that camera. Bring that. There it is. We got the drive shaft back in. You know, if you think about doing this job by yourself, you know, you want to just straight up and fucking forget it. My stern man, Bob J.
What's up?
Only reason I have all these freaking tools around, because he does all the work on my boat.
Where's
That's my mechanic.
Where's the rest of this set here?
Right in the top of this drawer right here. Right there, middle drawer. Right there. It's in there. I'll just pass you beers, huh?
Yeah.
Cool.
Freaking right.
All right, the plan is putting the undercarriage back in. We're trying to get the shape, somewhat the shape of this. And I'm going to control it by pulling on this track. But I'd have to let this go quite a bit, wouldn't I? That's not going to work. I'm going to have to. Two-person job, man. No cameras. Yeah, it wasn't a hard job at all. It's just, I can't stress it enough to have somebody else with you, because I really don't think you could do it by yourself. Honestly, I don't think you could do it. Be some swearing, kicking shit around, I'll tell you that. No, definitely two-person job. Drive shaft all back in. First two bolts of the carriage. Right. So we get the front carriage bolts in, and then we get carried away, and I forgot to film, but we had the whole thing laid on the floor, and I just lowered the whole snowmobile right down onto that carriage, right onto the floor, and then my stern man Bub put the rear carriage bolts in it. We had up and down, you know, to get them lined up, but it wasn't that big a deal, really. I mean, it's just the rear carriage, just matter of picking it up. So that really worked out quite well. So we're in the process now of putting the gears back in, and just in the matter of just as we took them out, we're putting them back in. Alright, so we have the track back on, carriage all tightened up. We're into this gearbox. We've put a cotter pin back in here like it's supposed to be. Tighten this up. This chain is now tight, just finger tight. I don't know exactly how tight it should be, but it wasn't flopping around like it was before. We get Loctite on all threads. All the gears are back. And this now has a bolt in it, which it didn't before, and with Loctite on it. And we get the gasket on, cleaned. And we're cleaning the cover at this point. We put the secondary back on. Adjusted the deflection. It's a little high right now, but I think it'll loosen up once we
rotate the engine a little bit. I mean, a little low, to be honest with you. But everything's tightened up. And let's see, get the cover on. My steering man, Bob J's putting on right now, if we can get it in there. The exhaust is going to go on after that and be ready to fire up. Is she going to fit? Pretty stiff. Ah, you got it. Man, that is a tight fit, ladies and gentlemen. I'll tell you what. She is in.
She is in.
We're going to have to do a repair to the plastic. Well, we had to notch that a little bit, get the springs in there with a vibrating saw. We're going to, once it's all together, we'll take and put a little 5200 down around there and seal that all back up. But I don't see how else you could have done it, really, honestly. So we just got some bolts to put back in here and put the linkage back on, exhaust, and fire this mother up. Well, linkage is on, exhaust back on, all the springs and all that. Secondary is back in order.
Let's hear it.
I think we're ready to fire this son of a bitch up.
That's right. We are.